Hello and welcome, guys. Thank you for joining me again for another night of Facebook Live. I also like to take time out to recognize those that catch the replay from YouTube and or SoundCloud. It is indeed a blessing to be here with you tonight. I am your host, Antricia Bray Smith, author, educator, and public speaker. Tonight, we're on our sixth night of the Untapped mini series. And tonight we're going to talk from the subtopic of the moments of vulnerability. The moments of vulnerability. As you guys are logging on with me tonight, feel free to like and share this video. Also, guys, feel free to give me a shout out and let me know that you're here with me tonight, as it's always a blessing to have you guys here with me as we are discussing our topics. Erica, it's good to see you tonight, hon. Also, in the comment section, guys, you can see that I put the link if you would like to order your Untapped t-shirt. There are several that you will see on our online store. Feel free to go and just take a look around to see what we have to offer. Also, if you haven't already liked and subscribed to our YouTube channel, please go ahead and click that link and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you can catch videos on demand. Everything that we do here at night on Facebook Live is uploaded to the YouTube channel. So for any reason, if it's something that you missed or a topic that you want to go back and revisit, those are housed there in our YouTube library for you to view. And also, guys, for those of you who are interested in any books and resources that I have available, the link to my website is there. Feel free to go and take a look. And you can always contact me through that link on my website. You can always contact me there. Nonetheless, I appreciate you guys that are here with me tonight. Don't forget to send me a shout out or say hello just to let me know that you're there. I do appreciate to know who's with me. And to, if you did the homework or if you accepted the challenge that I laid out before you last night, to consider that person that you said that you trust and reach out and share one or more of the things that you have helped had covered for any amount of time, then tonight you will be able to relate to some of the things that I'm talking about. Because after we take that leap and, or we take that risk in exposing our secret or our feelings, then it's like we're naked. And that is the feeling that we get. And that comes with all kinds of different emotions. It comes with all kinds of different thoughts and nervousness and anxiety. And so this is what we want to talk about tonight, what that looks like. It's the moments of vulnerability after we have exposed or shared our secrets. Hey, Rita, how are you tonight, honey? It's good to have you here on the live with me tonight. So so this is what we want to talk about tonight, because, guys, regardless of what it is that we share, regardless of what it is that our secret that we've kept hitting over and over and over again that has us bound and confined to a certain area, a certain place, or a certain time in our life, it's not going to be easy. And to some people, it may seem like a little bitty thing. Some people, it may seem like a huge thing. But whatever it is and however it looks to you or for you in your life, we know that it's not easy. It takes a lot of strength. It takes a lot of courage. It takes a lot of humility to get to the point to where we trust somebody enough to where we're going to share our secret or our thoughts or a traumatic experience or just something that about us that maybe somebody didn't know? Did you feel like it's necessary for them to know? Something that has us bound by our thoughts, something that holds us captive, something that keeps us from moving forward and always looking in the rearview mirror and never being able to really get out of that rut, of that cycle in our life, because we're always worrying about somebody exposing us. So I said that when we do the work and go through this process of what it looks like to actually deal with the issues that are in our closet rather than suppressing it and keeping it hidden, then we begin to free ourselves. We no longer have to have the validation of others to get that level of freedom and affirmation. We lose all the power that someone else or that this thing has had on us when we expose it. And so as we talked last night about trusting, and we know that it wasn't going to be easy. We know that it was going to take some level of courage and some level of strength and some level of wisdom, even in knowing who to confide in or who to share with. You know, we know that it's not going to be an easy deal to sit down and tell our spouse that we really don't love them, or that we married them for security, or that we don't have a intimate feeling toward them, or that we have a natural affection for someone else. It is not easy to sit down and tell our mothers that we hate them, or that we have all this anger built up inside because we feel like they didn't protect us, or that we have resentment toward her because she was an addict and sold us off to her pimps, and she neglected us for her own selfish needs or for her own needs. It's not going to be easy to tell a dad or uncle or brother or cousin that we resent them for the hurt and the trauma that they've imposed upon us. It's not easy to sit down and to tell our children that we really don't know who their daddy is, and that they were conceived through a rape, or conceived in unfavorable conditions, or through a traumatic experience. It's not easy to really begin to pull up the skeletons in the closet and lay it out on the line. It's not easy to go to a friend and tell the friend how you resent them and how you feel like they've deceived you or betrayed you all these years, and you just acted as a friend and you really don't have that compassion and stuff for them. These are all emotions and feelings and anger and things that we have in us that we keep hidden and suppressed. And many times it's to either protect ourselves or to protect someone else. And what it does is it continues to hold us bound. It continues to keep our own emotions and our own feelings suppressed. And sometimes it's just hard to process that. So if you did the exercise from last night, if you accepted the challenge and you found that one somebody that you could trust to share something with, even if it was just a little bit of something, even if it was not the whole story, even if it was just part of what you really want to say, I commend you for finding that strength in doing that. I commend you for in doing that. But as a result of that, there is no way that I would tell you that going through that exercise or going through that process is going to be easy, or that it has been easy. Because on the flip side of that, when you expose yourself, it's like walking out the house naked with no clothes on. Because now somebody knows something about you that is so intimate that you may have never even shared before. And so in our own minds, we're taking on new grounds. We're taking and experiencing and treading new territory. And it's unfamiliar to us. So this is what puts us in those moments of vulnerability. Because immediately in our mind, we begin to second guess whether or not we should have shared that information. And we begin to second guess whether or not it was the right person to share that information with. And we begin to think, oh no, I shouldn't have did it. And now our mind wants to tread back and go back and look back at familiar territory. And this is natural, guys, because experiencing new things causes us anxiety. It causes us to be vulnerable because we're moving into places and we're taking on grounds that is unfamiliar to us. The pain, the trauma, the betrayals, the secrets, whatever, that's familiar to us. That's where we've camped out all these years. That's what we're enslaved to. This is where our secrets lie. This is our safety of those strongholds. But when we begin to move out of that, this is where our vulnerability begins to show up. And it's showing up not as if it is all true or that we should or that we have a right to fear, but it's because of our minds. It's because of our bodies. It's because of we going into new territory. So newness is a fear for us to take on something new. Many of us, you know, if we could just get up and go somewhere, go to a new city or go to a new place or a new home or something like that, sometimes that's all that's holding some of us back. But the fear of the unknown, not knowing to expect once we get there, or being vulnerable and exposed and having to entertain ourselves and get to know new people, that is what holds so many of us back. So if you found the strength to share, if you found the strength to write it down, remember I said you may not be at that point to where you find somebody that you can trust. You may need to be one that write it down and be able to speak it and to look at it for yourself. It may have been the first time you've ever take a look at who you really are. It may be the first time you really take a look at yourself and say, you know, I'm a pedophile. Or you may have taken a look at yourself and said, I'm a thief, or I'm a liar, or I can't be trusted, or I'm a control fanatic, or I'm an abuser. You know, it may be the first time you've actually gotten real with yourself and looked at yourself for who you really are. Because we're so busy masking ourselves and covering up and dressing up for everybody else. It may be the first time that you really take a long, hard look at yourself in the mirror and say, you know what, I'm addicted, or I'm depressed, or I have a mental illness that I know is there and I have not dealt with it. And I've inflicted all this pain upon everybody else, have everybody else manipulated, thinking that it's them and it's me. And guys, we're going to be vulnerable. Anytime we expose ourselves, we're going to be vulnerable. And it is a natural healing process. And it's that vulnerability, it's that being naked, it's that taking on new grounds that keeps so many people preferring to stay in bondage. preferring to stick to those things that are familiar, preferring to continue to live their life bound up and never breaking those strongholds and getting that deliverance that they need to really live that abundant life or to tap into that life that they know that they are destined for. So the moments of vulnerability, do not discount it. Feel all of that. But as you're feeling all of that, know that your emotions can be deceiving. Let me say that again. Don't discount what you feel. Don't discount any of it. It's valid. It's human nature. We're going to feel that way. We're exposed. We're taking on new ground. But don't allow those moments of vulnerability and that desire to go back and be bound. Don't let it draw you back there. Your emotions are deceiving. It's not about emotions. Many of us were so caught up in what we feel like that we discount what we know. We discount what we believe. And this is why it's so easy for other people who are manipulators and controllers and people that play people like puppets on the string. This is how come it's so easy for them to do that. They read us. They see us coming. They can spot us a mile away. Have you ever wondered how people can be brainwashed and they can be part of these organizations and things like this to where it's so easy for people to just tell them what to do, how to do, when to do, where to go? You know, that's why. Because it's all about an emotion, something that feels good. But this is not about that. Your emotions can deceive you. Focus more on that you know. Focus more on that you believe. And this is what you have to ask yourself. And this is how you gain your footage in knowing that, yes, I'm naked and exposed right now. Yes, I'm in a place of vulnerability. Yes, I'm in a place where my emotions are all over the place and I just want to go back and hide in the closet. But do you know that the more you press forward, the more you keep treading forward, the more you keep your mind focused on what's ahead of you and the work that you're trying to do in getting your healing and getting your deliverance, that it's going to be so much better. Because that moment of vulnerability or that moment of being exposed or that moment of being naked, it is just that. It's a moment. And it is our own mind that is magnifying that moment. No one really judges us. We're judging ourselves. No one really wants to see us bound up. We're binding ourselves up. We have manipulated ourselves. We have fooled ourselves for so long that we're just operating out of emotions. So whatever I feel that way, that's the way I'm going to move. And if I don't feel it, I ain't going to move. But remember, it's not about what we feel. It's about what we know, and it's about what we believe. And when you're working on a process of being healed and delivered and set free and loosen the power of your secrets and working on the issues that we've had locked up in the closet time and time again, it's just a part of the process. So don't allow anyone to make you believe otherwise. And remember, if you share with somebody and they're negative, or they do not support you in a way that you feel like, or that you know, or that you believe you should be supported, then remember, either they're hurting or in a situation to where they cannot give you that support or the affirmation that you need, or that is our Creator's way of showing us that they've gone with you as far as that they can go with you. It's time for you to outgrow them and press forward. Or it's just that, hey, you've seen them all along, but it never really came to your mind that this is who they are. Remember, we try to make people out to be sometimes people that they're not. And when people have their own issues and they're stuck in a rut and they can't press forward and they're not trying to do the work on them, many times that's what they speak to us. And so when they're bound up, everything that they speak is going to be bound. But remember, they're not the ones that's changing and going through and growing and going through this process. You are. And sometimes that means that we lose friends. Sometimes that means that the relationship with mom or dad looks a little bit different, or the relationship with our spouses or whoever. That means that as we change, our circumstances change. Now, that does not mean that we try to force them to change, or try to force them to see differently, or try to force them to be a certain way. It just means that we stand on the ground that we know and believe that we are making the progress toward our healing. And maybe, just maybe, through them seeing us go through the process without trying to impose our feelings or our emotions upon them, just maybe they'll see something that they will desire to go through the same process. Maybe just not at the same time as us. Hey, Keisha, how are you? Glad you're with me tonight. Miss Green, glad to see you. So yes, if we're doing the work, if we're taking the steps, it's just like going through a process of grief. It's all about steps and being aware of what those steps look like. If I sit here and I tell you tonight, I am addicted to porn, so there are certain things that I will not allow my mind to watch, or there are certain things that I will not allow my ears to hear. There are certain things that I will not allow my eyes to see, because that is a part of who I am. And if I allow myself to see or hear or touch or feel these things, it ignites that hidden area or that suppressed area in my mind. And so it takes me back to a place that is familiar that I don't desire to go. So now, being that I share that, I'm naked and I'm exposed and I'm in a vulnerable state and my emotions are all over the place and I'm triggered to go back and I think back on some of the things that fostered that feeling or those desires in me. And so I think back to that place. That's what vulnerability looks like. It's revisiting that. It's emotions all over the place. It's, why did I tell that? It's why am I dealing with this? Why am I feeling that? But it is necessary, because the more I can tell it, the more I can share it, the more I recognize it, the more I'm aware of it, the better chance and the better opportunity I have of overcoming that thing that has held me bound and that has had so much power in my life. So as it exposes, as I expose it, it no longer dictates, or it no longer gives me an identity, or it no longer keeps me bound to that place. I no longer have to be ashamed that this is an area that I struggle in. And it's going to be the same with you, with whatever your issues is, whatever you have kept hidden, whatever you don't want everybody to know about you for whatever reason. You yourself cannot be afraid to look it in the face, expose it, and rip it up its power, whereas it has you in a place to where you're having to worry about whether or not you're going to be exposed or whether or not someone knows your secret. So the moments of vulnerability, it is just that. It's just a moment. In our mind, we make it seem like it's so much more, but it's just a moment. And I'd rather go through that moment and feel all those feelings and feel all those emotions and walk through it and get through it knowing that I'm set free and believing that the God and the creator that I serve has me in mind and that he is directing my steps. So that moment of vulnerability versus the rest of my life, I think I'll run on and see what's ahead of me. I hope that this topic tonight has been helpful for you. I do appreciate all of you that have been here since day one of this series. We have one more night of this Untapped mini series. And I hope that you'll be able to join me tomorrow night as we try to get all of this stuff and wrap it up and begin to take on new grounds in our life, begin to pull out some of those things that we've kept hidden and suppressed that causes us so many issues in our life and keeps us from moving forward. So I hope that you'll be here with me tomorrow night as we begin to go through that. Go ahead and hit those heart buttons. Show me some love tonight. Let's show our sisters and brothers some love tonight. Let them know that we're here to support one another. Also, guys, my challenge for you tonight is to sit in the vulnerability, sit in those emotions, take it in, be aware of all that you're feeling. Because if you're feeling it now, it's just a moment. But remember, our emotions can be deceiving. It's more about what we know and what we believe, okay? I am your host, Antricia Bray Smith, author, educator, and public speaker. I'll see you right back here again tomorrow night at 10 p.m. Good night, everybody.